So before we go into how exactly Tomasulo's algorithm works, let's kind of see an overview picture of what's going on in there, just like what the hardware structurally looks like. So first, there is an instruction queue, which I labeled here IQ. Instructions come from the fetch unit in the order in which they were fetched, and again, these are only floating point instruction, and then they're queued up here. So this is basically like, this is the kind of oldest instruction, the next one, the next one, the next one, and we will be kind of, you know, dropping these instructions into the Tomasulo's algorithm machine in the order in which they came. We always grab the next available instruction from the instruction queue, and we want to put it into a reservation station. There are a number of reservation stations that basically when one becomes available, we will put an instruction into one of those. And reservation stations are where instructions basically sit for their parameters to become ready. There is a floating point register file, so this is where your floating point registers are, and when an instruction is inserted into a reservation station, the values that are already in registers, meaning the values that are actually already present and ready for execution, are going to be simply entered into the reservation station from the register file. Once an instruction is actually ready to execute, it goes to an execution unit, and you can have different types of execution units. So, for example, this is an adder, and this is a multiplier. So simple floating point instructions would be done in the kind of adder unit, and the more complicated, like multiply and divide, would be done in the multiplier unit. Each of these units really had separate reservation stations where instructions that are going to that unit would wait. Once such a unit has produced a result, the result will be broadcast on a bus. So of course the result would go to the register file. So pretty much all the results that are ready would be available in the register file so that instructions that come in would simply grab them from there and we don't have to worry about where those values are going to come from. But these results would also be broadcast to the reservation stations. Why? Well, because there are instructions here that are waiting for values that they need to be produced. And as values are produced, we need to tell these instructions that, you know, now your value has been produced. So they need to also go here. So pretty much here you have some values that you already have in an instruction, some values that you're waiting for, and you know what you're waiting for. And then when the value is finally broadcast, you check for each of the value that is broadcast, whether this is the one we are waiting for or not. Now, I have two of these per reservation station because a typical instruction will actually have two inputs, like, for example, you're adding two numbers. And when you broadcast a result, either of the two or both of them might need that result. So, for example, if you're doing something like add R1, R1, and the instruction that is producing R1 is currently in the multiplier, when it broadcasts the result and says this is R1, we want to latch it into maybe both of the operands for this instruction. So you need to compare basically what's being broadcast. Its name needs to be compared to both of the inputs that you are waiting for. And then you select the one or both of them, or none of them, if this is not the value you're waiting for. And finally, if the instruction is not an arithmetic instruction, if it's actually a load into the floating point register file or a store from it, then the instruction would go to the address generation unit. That's an integer operation, so it's not gonna go through that. So basically, we just compute the address, and then we insert the instruction into the load buffer or a store buffer, where the instructions are going to be queued up for going to memory. And the load buffer only provides the data address. The store buffer provides both the address and the data to memory. When a load comes back from memory, its value is also broadcast on the CDB and goes to the appropriate register. And also, all the values that are broadcast from the bus are going to go here, so that stores can get their values when they become available. So a store instruction that needs to put a value in memory is going to wait for its floating point value that needs to be placed to memory until it becomes available and only then be sent to the memory. Unlike arithmetic instructions, which can execute out of order, basically they only wait for inputs to become available and then they can go, for loads and stores, they were done in order, so basically they didn't reorder loads and stores, and we will later consider how to do that. Modern processors will actually reorder loads and stores too. So this is a lot simpler than in modern processors, but this here is pretty much the way it's done now, modulo some small adjustments. So before we go into kind of the details of Tomasulo algorithm, let's just kind of give names to some things on this picture, and then we will kind of discuss what each of these things really needs to do. So this part here, where we send the instruction from the instruction queue into the reservation stations and the load store unit, is called issue. When the instruction is finally sent to execution from a reservation station, it's called dispatch. And when the instruction is ready to broadcast its result, we call that write result, or simply broadcast. So basically every instruction will be issued, meaning get to the reservation station. Eventually it gets to dispatch because all of its inputs are ready and it's kind of gets to go to the unit. Once it's done, it's going to write the result, and that is when we consider the instruction completed. So now let's see what happens when you issue, when you dispatch, and when you write result.